Hey guys, this is a Ranger 570 full-size video. Just running you through the oil change procedure real quick. It's not complicated, but if you've never done it before, these kind of videos can help you. I know I look for them all the time when I get a new piece of machinery. So first thing, the entire area underneath the engine is covered by a skid plate. The drain holes are not always in ideal locations, so you always do have some oil that runs, you know, further than you think it will, and it'll come out a hole that's, you know, 12 inches behind your engine, so it's hard to catch it with a drain pan. What I always do when I change the oil in this thing is get a drop cloth, like the type you'd use for painting. They're super cheap. I usually buy 4 or 5 at a time and just keep them in the garage. So I'll throw a big plastic drop cloth underneath kind of the whole area I'm working in, and you can see that pool of oil right there. That's oil that I missed in my catch pan. So, you know, probably cost you $1 to keep a drop cloth around, but it can save you some cleanup after. So, getting into it, the drain plug for this vehicle, this engine I should say, is located underneath, kind of in the center of the engine. If you go under the vehicle, you'll see a kind of an oblong drain hole. If you look up through that, you'll see an Allen head bolt. That is a 6 millimeter Allen head, at least it is on mine, on my 570. Other engines may be different. It doesn't have very much torque on it. I think the manual calls out 12 foot-pounds, which is not much at all. So just get your Allen key under there and break it loose with the palm of your hand and thread it out. And while your oil is draining out of that hole, make sure you clean your bolt very well. There's also a brass washer on the bolt, so take that off of the bolt and clean both sides of it, make sure it looks good. If it has a flaw in it or doesn't look good, you can get a replacement. They're very cheap and worthwhile to do. It can keep you from leaking, or you know, those annoying little drips you get on your garage floor when something's not sealed perfectly well, so make sure you pay some attention to that. After that, or while your oil's draining, you can do them both at the same time. You need to change out your oil filter. I always use Wix filters personally, but you know, everyone has their preference. K&N filters are also very good, but I would stay away from like a Fram filter. My opinion, those are the cheapest filters on the planet. You can tell the weight difference just by picking up a Wix versus a Fram. You know, the Wix weighs twice as much. It's got probably twice as much filter media on the inside. So definitely put a high quality filter on. These things are expensive. You want them to run a long time. So pull your filter off. I've always been able to get mine by hand. I never had to use a cap wrench or anything like the manual recommends. So just turn that lefty-loosey, your old filter, and thread it off. You will get a little draining out of that filter. A trick that I found to work pretty well is take a piece of cardboard and bend it into a V and work it up under next to the engine so it's underneath that filter and it'll catch anything that runs out when you're unscrewing it. And then make your cardboard long enough so that it'll reach down to this hole here. And then as that oil drains, it's only an ounce or two, but as it drains, it'll run down that cardboard and get close to this hole and run out into your pan. Keeps you from having to clean up your skid plate. You can see there's always mud and everything packed up in there. And it's a pain in the you know what to clean up once you get oil on it. So do that. Once your old filter's off, toss it away. Take your new filter of your choice, and lubricate the O-ring with some of your new engine oil that you're going to be using. And just take your finger and dip it in the oil and run it around that. Make sure there's a coating on it at least. And then clean off your filter sealing surface just with a rag or a paper towel. Make sure there's no oil or residue and it looks perfectly clean and shiny. And thread your new filter on. You want to thread it to the point where it just makes contact with that sealing surface, and then you want to turn it like a quarter to a half a turn. You know, you don't need a lot of torque on that. It'll just make it harder to get off once you change the oil the next time. So after that's on, you can go back down to your drain plug. All your oil should be drained out by now. And your bolt should be clean, because we did that already. And clean off that sealing surface as well with a rag. It'll still be dripping, you know, a microscopic amount, but don't worry about it. Just wipe it off as best you can, clean it up. thread your new bolt in. As I said, the torque spec is 12 foot-pounds, which is basically a pretty light pressure on a 6-inch long Allen key. So don't over torque it. You risk stripping it out or breaking the bolt. Although the bolt's pretty beefy, just don't over torque it is what I'm getting at. After that, you can remove your dipstick, which goes in that hole right next to the filter. And the purpose for removing that is just to provide some ventilation so the air has somewhere to go while you're dumping the new engine oil in. So leave that out. You can come up here to the top of your engine, your valve cover area. You'll have this fill plug will be installed in there, your fill cap. So drop that, unscrew that, take it out. You want to put 2 quarts of clean oil in. I personally run Polaris oil in all my Polarises, but everyone has an opinion when it comes to oil. You know, some people like AMS oil, some people like Mobil 1, 4T. I just go with the manufacturer recommended because it's not that much more expensive than any other type of oil, and I know that I won't have any warranty issues or anything like that. So I run the Polaris PS4 5W50 full synthetic. If you are running another type of oil, I would just recommend that it's 5W50 full synthetic. So a trick for filling it, and I do this with pretty much everything I have. Not sure if anybody else does this or not, but I have a 2-liter bottle, which is that guy down there. And it holds 2 liters, which the Polaris manual calls for 1.9 liters of oil to be added, which is 2 quarts. If you want the conversion, but I just draw a little line on a 2-liter. I clean it out very well. When I get a new piece of equipment, I'll get a new 2-liter bottle and I'll flush it out with whatever engine oil weight the machine calls for. So I'll dump a few ounces in, rotate it around, drain it out really well so that I know the whole inside of the bottle is coated with the new oil. And then I will drain that out. And then I will fill it with the recommended amount of oil that the machine takes after an oil change. So in this case, it's 1.9 liters, which is almost a full 2-liter bottle. And then I will strike a line on that bottle at that 1.9 liter mark. And then I will tag it with the name of the machine that it's for. So if you look over on my shelf, actually they're out in the barn, I have a 2-liter bottle for every machine that I have with a line corresponding to the amount of oil that it takes. So when I go to fill it, I just take my gallon jug that I got from Polaris, fill it up to that line, and then I dump it into the machine. It's very handy because you can cap up the 2-liter bottle when you're done with it, so it stays clean and dust-free. On this machine, you do have enough room to dump the 2-liter directly into that hole, so you don't even need a secondary funnel. I have a funnel just because I just used it to fill another machine yesterday that needed a funnel, so I had it and I knew it was clean, so I just chose to use it, but you don't have to if you're careful. And it's just a quick trick so you don't have to do a whole lot of measuring other than the first time you put your bottle system together. So just a quick tip, and feel free to use it or not. After you've dumped your 2 quarts or 1.9 liters of oil into your engine, you replace that cap. Then you go back down and replace your dipstick cap. And then I usually fire it up and let it run for 2 to 3 minutes, just get some heat on the engine and circulate that oil around. And then I check my oil. So your level should be perfect. On this machine, it falls pretty much right in the middle between low and high mark on the dipstick. So you should be good to go at that point. Make sure everything's good, check for leaks. You know, you shouldn't have any if you followed the procedure that I laid out, but just get your head underneath there and make sure nothing's leaking. And you are good to go. Congratulations, you just changed your oil. Hope this helps somebody out. Thanks.